This tutorial is part of our full stack React Django DRF channels project, DJ Chat. You can watch this tutorial and many more from our YouTube course playlist, or the whole course, including access to additional resources from our Udemy course. The Udemy course link, which provides the best price for the course, is in the video description. Since we created the repository, we have now undertaken quite a lot of work, and there has been many different changes to our project. We have installed or created a virtual environment. We've gone ahead and configured Visual Studio Code for both Flake 8 and Black. So now potentially we want to record the fact that we've made those changes and commit these changes to our repository. So this essentially is a way of saving the current state, the current code base of our application, so that should we then continue developing, we can then potentially roll back to when we created this commit. So potentially, let's just imagine, for example, we build an application, we make some changes, and then all of a sudden we've completely messed up everything in our code base. And we're not too sure exactly what changes we made because it's quite a complex piece of code. So what we can do here is we can roll back to when we last committed, made a commit, when we knew that the application was working successfully. If you take a look at GitHub Desktop, you can see that we have now created 7,419 changes. Now, most of these changes are related to the virtual environment, the fact that there are so many files inside of the virtual environment. And this then leads us towards a concept or an idea that we don't necessarily want to record all of the changes related to our project folder, all the changes that were made in within our repository. So we need a way of potentially ignoring some of these different folders and files. So what we're going to do is we're going to utilize git ignore. This will allow us to define or tell git not to track certain files and folders. So inside of, let's place this inside of the, inside of our project here. I was in the wrong folder. So let's go ahead and create a new file. We're going to call this .git ignore. Okay, so just .git ignore. So here we're going to define which folders and files not to track in our repository. So something we don't want to track is the virtual environment folder. So that is definitely something that we can define. So we can define a folder. Let's type in the name of the folder and then slash. All right, so in addition to that, we will be creating a database file. Now we don't want to necessarily store that in the repository. So we're going to add that in too. Now we haven't created that yet, but we just preempt that. Now, in addition to that, what we probably don't want to store in the repository is the environment variables. These are meant to be sensitive data that we don't necessarily want to have in our code base. So in addition to that, we don't necessarily want to actually store this in our repository, because anyone who has access to our repository, if it isn't private, for example, will also be able to access all of our secret information. So what we might want to do here, in actual fact, if we are going to share this project with others, is we might want to just copy and paste that and then go ahead and let's just call this example environment or environment example, however you want to name it. So we're going to call this example. Okay, and then what we can do here is we can remove our actual keys, and let's just call this example. And then put debug true. Right, so that would then potentially be utilized in the commit so that anyone who accesses our project, they know what environment variables will need to be set. But of course, they won't have actual access to the actual variables that we've defined in our project. So let's go ahead and just make sure that in our git ignore file here, we're going to ignore .env. Okay. All right, so notice what's happening here when I'm doing this. Because of the built-in tools in Visual Studio Code, you can see that as soon as I've applied this, they are being grayed out. You can see here that the two files that I've just added here in the git ignore file is now being grayed out. So the .env and the SQL file isn't being grayed out. And that just indicates the fact it's not being included. It's not included in the tracking of this repository. So if you're working on a Mac, likelihood is you want to also make sure we don't commit any .ds store files, just some additional metadata that Mac produces. And apart from that, what we can do is also add any cache. So Django will create cache. That will help improve the speed in which the program loads. So we want to just make sure we don't include that in our repository. And there we go. So that's probably a good start to begin with. Now, what you're going to notice here is that I mentioned that things are grayed out, which indicates the fact we're not going to track them. But notice here that I've also selected the .env folder and it's not grayed out. It's still being tracked. And that's because the ignore file is actually inside this folder here. So that isn't necessarily going to work because this file here is basically then going to be utilized for this folder, GJ Chat, and potentially any folders within the GJ Chat folder here. So we're going to potentially need to move this across to the root directory. So we can move that across. And now you can see potentially that the .env folder isn't going to be tracked. Now let's just make sure this is working. So you can see that that did take a couple of seconds to change, but now you can see the .env folder is being grayed out, so we're not going to be tracking that folder. But what we have here is a Django project within this folder, and potentially this is only related to that project. So you can see how you can potentially start to structure your gitignore files. You can have multiple gitignore files. Maybe here you want to just include .env, and then at this level here, if we were to add a gitignore file inside of DJ Chat, you might want to include these files. So it's up to you how you want to manage that, but we're just going to include the gitignore file on the root directory for now and just apply all these settings or all the changes that we want to make where we don't want to track those type of files or folders. So we can now see in GitHub Desktop that we have now removed nearly over 7,000 changes. And that leaves us with just the project. So we can just run through this and just double check that everything we have here is probably something that we want to actually record. So it looks okay. It looks like we're actually now just saving what it is that we want to record in our repository. Now there is one more thing that's missing here. If we were to save this in our repository and we wanted then to replicate our project somewhere else on maybe another machine, or if someone else were to want to access our code and replicate and build our application, there's a few critical things that are missing here. So remember, we've installed a number of different dependencies, packages, and we're going to need to be able to record those packages so that anyone who's going to replicate this project is able to then to identify what packages are needed to actually build and run our application successfully. In order to collect all of the dependencies that have been used or packages that have been used for this project, we just need to type in pip and then freeze and then write chevron and requirements.txt, and that will then create a new text file with all the packages that have been installed to run our application. So if we go back to GitHub Desktop, you can now see that has now been added into our repository, ready for us to now make our first commit. So hopefully we can summarize and better understand now when I say that a git commit is a record of changes to a file or set of files in a git repository. When we make changes to our code like we've done here, we can then go ahead and make a commit to actually create a new commit that captures those changes. So a commit contains a snapshot, if you like, of the files at a specific point in time, and a commit message that describes the changes that we've made. So here, down here, we can create a summary and a description of the changes that we've made. Looking at this a little bit wider, commits are also used as an essential part of collaborating with others on the project. It allows others, or allows you to share your changes with your team and ensures that everyone is working with the same code base. Now remember, like I mentioned, that we don't have to use GitHub Desktop here. We can use command line. So it is sometimes commonplace for developers to use commands to actually create commits, but there are so many different tools now available. This is really, in my opinion, the most simplistic way of managing your Git repository using GitHub Desktop. So now then, all we need to do is to create a commit is potentially just summarize the changes we've made. Now I'm just going to type in NC for new commit and then press commit to main. So go ahead and commit. Now what's happened now? We've created a commit. So what's important to remember here is that we have only made those changes and saved those changes here locally on our machine, which is absolutely fine. But we're going to be utilizing GitHub to actually save our repository in the cloud. So we just go ahead and push that to origin. So press push to origin, and then that will just be uploaded to our repository in GitHub or on GitHub. And now we can go ahead and view on GitHub. So select view on GitHub, that will open up a new browser, and we can now see all of the changes that we've made. They are now stored successfully here on GitHub. So as and when you're ready, throughout the development of this application, you can go ahead and make as many commits as you like. I will add in some additional techniques and give you some additional information about different features that you can include and use in your workflow when developing an application as we work through this project.